So about me, I'm from Bonn, from Ware Group. I'm working there. I'm in the MapBender team since a long time already. I'm not a developer. I'm more working on project management, running solutions with OSGEO software since a long time. And I work in the MapBender team to work on the concept, testing, documentation, and marketing. I'm also in the OSGEO Live team and on the board since some years. At Ware Group, we are the core developer of MapBender. So we are in Germany, in Bonn, Berlin, and Freiburg. And we have more than 40 employees. And if you are looking for a job, we are hiring. So come around and we could talk. So this is what we are doing. MapBender is a co-project, but we have a Metadoor, which is a tool for metadata, and Mops, which is an offline client. But now we want to have a look at MapBender, and if you're still here on Saturday, you're welcome to come around to the community sprint so we could have a closer look. But let's have a look what MapBender does. It's a WebGIS client suite with an administrative web interface. So if you're a non-developer, it may be interesting for you because you can use MapBender without writing a single line of code. There are a lot of WebGIS clients around, and we offer a toolbox with MapBender that helps you to create individual applications that could solve your needs. We create and maintain OWS repositories for your services, so you let MapBender know your services. We distribute configured services among applications, as many as you want, and we offer you to grant users, create users and groups, and grant them access to applications and services. So this is how the normal default application looks like. When you install MapBender, you get three default applications already created, and the easiest way is to copy them and then configure them and add your services so they will represent your data. We have a gallery in the MapBender project, so if you are interested, you can have a look there and find out about MapBender solutions. And here you can already see they look quite different. You can add your corporate design to modify the application to your corporate design. I would like to show you some slides from Rio. It's in Germany, close to Cologne. It's a commune, and they work with MapBender since a long time. And they, as you can see here, all the blue boxes, they represent thematic applications where they try to combine their services. They have a lot of services, maybe over 100, and they combine their services to for different needs and ship them in applications. Some of them are accessible in the internet, and some of them are only maybe internal for special groups. So you have the possibility to create applications, and we also, as before in the work in the presentation, we have a sidebar, we have a content part with a map, we have a toolbar, a footer with a lot of different functionality, and you can use whatever you want and sort how you like the modules that you would like to present in your application. In the sidebar, you can get an idea about the services. You can present as many services as you want in the application and can decide which one is active, which one is disabled by default. And in a minute, we will see how this is done in the backend. You have scale functionality. You can change the projection, you have the legend from the services. They are displayed in the application, either in the sidebar or in a dialog as you configure. You have a slider at each service, so you can define whether you want to have it more with more opacity, like you can see here. You have a redlining tool that you can make use to make sketches, and maybe you want to print them and give them to your colleagues. And you have the info, a feature info. So we support WMS services. So WMS services bring feature info with them. So if they offer it, you can get feature info. For example, you can use a search module. You can figure it with your data from a PostgreSQL database that did it here to offer an address search. And maybe this is my parcel with my house, and I can get information about my my parcel. And they offer we offer a module where you can make print outputs with attribute data. So you can define if you want not only the map, but want to print attributes, you can configure it in the backend administration. We have a module that helps you to add other services to your application. So while you are working in the application, you can add more services. Here you can see how you could change the application, so you can modify the positions of the sidebar, for example. And here, this is a solution from the city of Frankfurt. They have a lot of services as well. They have a simple application like this, and you get information as well about these parcels in Frankfurt and how expensive the ground is in that area. So maybe you think about buying a house here in the city of Frankfurt. You could measure an area and find out how many square meter you would have to buy. Then you could check how far it is to get to the next bar. And maybe if you have children, you would like to find out where the next school is or the next kindergarten or so. And if you find out that the next school is here around, you might find out how long this distance would be. So in Frankfurt, they implemented a routing functionality. So you have for school children, you have a routing, and it depends on how long the way is to school, so they will get a bus ticket or not. So you could find out whether this school would fit. And this routing functionality has a printout as well. So it's a routing that could be added to PG routing or Graphhopper. So this is what we implemented for the city of Frankfurt. This routing functionality is not in MapBender Core yet, but it's a thing that we would like to add with one of the next releases. And it's in use with some at some customers, and they paid for it. So this is the first look in the back end. So if you want to make your own applications, you would get, we call them elements. You have elements that you can configure, and each element has a different dialog where you have define the configuration for this element. And as you can see, it's not developer oriented like we saw before, but they are all forms where you can have checkboxes and so on. So you have this print functionality that we saw before, and here you can offer print templates from A4 till A0 that are there already, and you only have to add your logo or maybe some text from your individual city, and the rest is already there and easy to configure. You can rotate your print output, and like that you get a rotated map, and everything that you sketch in the map with a redlining tool or with the measurement tool will be also in the print. You can export images, and now we will have a look how it all works. So what do you have to do to set up your application? You have to log in, so you have to have the rights to create applications. And when you log in, you have an administration functionality that is there at the left. And you can see already that here in the application at the bottom, you get more functionality, so you can edit this application. If you want to make a new application, you just add an application, and we have different templates that you can choose. This one is, for example, the full screen template that we is selected here, but we have a mobile template as well, and you can create your individual templates. Then your application is there, but it's empty. It doesn't contain anything. We saw the application with all the elements, and either you copy an application, you get all the elements already, or you can start from scratch. So the first thing you would need is a map. So you add a map, and here you can see again that every element has some configuration that you have to do. So for the map element, you have to define the EPSG code, the bounding box, the scales that you would like to offer, and maybe some more information. So after you have the map, you would see this, because another thing you have to add are the services. So now you have to define which services you would like to offer in your application. We support WMS services at the moment, so you would have to register your services, and they you register them with the Get Capabilities request, and they will be stored in a database where all the information from the XML is stored. And then in the next step, you could go to your application bag and define layer sets that are collections of layer services that you would like to provide. So I created a main layer set, then I add the service. It's an OpenStreetMap service that covers the whole world. And here you can see that I could decide how this service should be loaded in the application. I could disable it, I could only activate one or two layers as I would like, or I could set opacity to a different value. So that's possible here in the back end. So like that, I could add some services to my application, and then I would have to say in the map element that my layer set main should be used. And if you open the application, then it's a bit better. And like this, I could add more and more elements to my application. If you want your corporate design visualized in the application, you can change the CSS of the application. So you override the default style of MapBender. You could do it dynamically in the application configuration like this, or you could ship CSS files or SCSS files and put them as a central space and then ship them with all your applications. You can create users, as I mentioned before. So I could create a user, and I can create groups, and you can assign the user to a group. And afterwards, you could define in which application this user or group should get access rights. Okay, that was the story on how you can create applications. When you have an application ready, it can be duplicated several times, so you could ship applications for different needs. And now I want to show you some more features that you have out of the box. So you could use this meeting point application, where you can click in the map, and then it will generate an URL that you could use to send it to someone to get to this location. We have a coordinate tool where you can grab a coordinate from the map, or where you can insert a coordinate and then zoom to this map. We have an application, we saw this before, where you can configure via YAML. That's the syntax that we sometimes use for formats to configure, for example, here a search. You could add different searches to your application, and it's really easy to configure them. So here you have an address search. You could define select boxes or autocomplete fields, and can easily jump to your location. So this is how this search module could look like. So you have this YAML code where you define the connection to your database, to your table, which columns you would like to need, where your geometry column is, how the form should look like, and which results should be shipped back. We also support Solr Search. So if you have a Solr service running, you can integrate a Solr Search to your application. It could look like this, or here like this, in this application for Metropole Ruhr. And you have a switcher, we call it Bayesor switcher, where you could, when you don't like the tree in your application, you could use this possibility to define select boxes, where you could switch from one service to another. You can create dynamic maps where you go to the feature info, and then maybe via feature info add additional information to the map like this. We have land use areas, and you could add the raster service dynamically via feature info. You can save configurations. So here some configurations are saved, and you can easily jump to these configurations from this select box. This is another nice example from a city of Troisdorf. They have many services as well, and you can structurize them with the layer set names that you could display in the application. This is a nice tool as well, a feature as well. So you can create elements for HTML content. So you could create an impressum or a help page, or in this case, I created this image in the corner at the right. So I had to create the HTML syntax to create an image, and then I can easily add information to the map, to the application. We have a mobile template where you can configure the same, but it's specialized for the mobile phone. And we have a nice tool that's more and more in fashion, where you can add digitized functionality, and you can create or edit and all sort of data. Depends on your needs. So this is an application where you can control trees or add trees and collect all sort of attributes for this data. And you see you can define a select box or date picker, checkboxes, text fields, and it's defined in this YAML syntax that you saw before. And it's, that's quite nice. And we have a dimension handler where you can, if you have services that support dimensions, you could add a dimension handler and have a slider in the application. So it needs a WMS with time support. We have some tools where you can check configuration. They are on the command line, or we have a new tool where you can print on the command line, do automatic prints. We have an element where you can create objects without geometry. And we have a query builder. So these are not in the core, but they are pluggable, where you could create a query and then get information depending on your query. So all these elements are documented on the website, so you can always get help about how to configure them. Maybe just some background information. MapBender is MIT license. We use Symfony as PHP framework, OpenLayers and jQuery. You always need a database for all the administrative information. So everything you click in the application is stored in the database. And we are on OSGeo Live since a long time. So if you want to try out MapBender, it's easy. You only have to check out OSGeo Live and can explore what's possible. We are planning a new release. So we are at the moment in version 3.8, and there's a new bug fix release coming soon. So you get all the downloads from the MapBender website, you get all the new versions, we have a Docker image that you could use, and we are working on a new version 3.1, where we want to update our OpenLayers version. We are working on this since quite a while, but it's nearly done now. So we want to have release 3.1 ready in 2019 with OpenLayers 4 support and Symfony 3.4, and focus on responsive design to combine mobile and desktop application in one application. Okay, so after 3.1, we want to make the website relaunch, and this is powered by OSGeo, because we get money from OSGeo as an OSGeo project, and we want to work on reusable service instances, so you have to configure them once for one application, and then you can ship them to other applications. And as you saw, we have this routing tool that we would like to integrate in the core. Yeah, and if you are German-speaking or close to Bonn and you have time at the 10th of October, we have a member meeting, so you can come around and talk a whole day about MapBender. So I hope you got to know MapBender through this presentation, and that's it. So are there any questions?
Thank you, Astrid. Quick question. You saw this feature of overlaying raster files as well. And rasters, so like land cover, I thought. What type of projections do one uses. I guess it's a fixed projection. There's no option for changing projections there. Yeah.
Okay. So you saw in the application that you can offer this option to change the projection, and it's always depending on the service. So when you publish a WMS service, you define which projections you want to support. And at the moment, you only can, in your application, you should only list these projections, because if you list a different one, MapBanner doesn't transform the data to a projection that is not supported by the service. So if you are in charge of the services by yourself, it's easy, and you have to keep in mind. But we are discussing about making the calculation in MapBanner to not get no map because the projection is not supported. Some more questions? Okay, so you have a question?
You are planning to implement some kind of routing interface. I am interested in this routing interface. Would it be graphical, or would it be only a programming interface for routing?
Whether it will be graphical?
Yes, would it be graphical, or would it be only a programming interface for routing?
Mm-hmm.
The routing in MapBanner in API?
So the routing is provided not by MapBanner, but we ask the as a routing engine. So we know the coordinates and then send the request to pgrouting or Graphhopper, so the routing will be done there. And we only display the route and the directions. Yeah, I hope this.
So it would be in backend, yes? Wouldn't it be graphically configurable from the front end?
No, the end user only can put in the address or the coordinate, and then the routing service is asked. But you couldn't configure it on your own in the application itself. In the backend, yes, but in the application itself, you couldn't. Mm-hmm. Okay. Oh, now more questions.
Hello. Actually, two questions. First one is it possible to install MapBanner in a secured environment on premises? And the second one, can it be extended by my own widgets, which I will be able to develop and integrate into application configuration console?
So, okay, the first question was whether it can run in secure services. So we have a proxy that you can use. So the service is not displayed outside, but also every time the proxy is asked to ship the raster or the information from the feature info. So like this, Your service, if it is not reachable from outside, it should be fine through this process to access the service. And the second question, sorry, I didn't.
About adding my own elements, my own widgets to MapBanner.
Yes, sure. So, yes. Okay, yes, you can, for sure, you can add your own widgets. We use Symfony and it's pluggable. We use plugins and we make bundles for you can make a bundle for your own functionality. And if you are a PHP programmer and know how to program, you could easily write your own elements. In the documentation, we have some example, so you can learn how to make simple elements. And if you have a look in the code, you see how the elements are created and maybe can adopt them to your needs. Someone else? There was one question. Maybe you come.
Thanks for this presentation. I can see that from the user side of making a map, you don't need to write any lines of code, and it seems very accessible in order to making applications, making maps. But my question is on the installation side. Is this something that users who aren't with a developer background would be able to easily install MapBanner on a server environment, or is that more of a technical challenge?
Okay, so one thing. We have to understand MapBanner doesn't make maps, only the application, no problem. And we only access the services. So And for installation, you need a web server, so you need Apache, you need PHP, and I think we have quite a good installation description, so it should work. And if you use Windows, you could use MS4W to check it, and on Linux you could use OSGU Live if you just want to explore it. Okay, so thanks a lot, and let's go for the next slide.